4th July 1999 was the date which was decided for the attack on Point 4875. You would have seen in movies, a lot of, you know, serials you would have read and all those things, you know, fought well, got injured, got shot, later on succumbed to the injuries, victory, loss. You all would have heard about it. But let me tell you about something about a soldier's mind. So how does a soldier think? What does he think? How does he feel just before going for the attack? Now, what are the traditions? What are the formalities we follow before launching the attack? Attack, of course, I'll come later. Fourth afternoon, I had meal with all my Jawan sitting together. It was a Charlie company which had to lead the attack. My company commander, Major Gurpreet Singh, and I had to follow him. So we had lunch together with all the men, just trying to assess the mood of this company. After that, as I told you, my helper Shyam Singh, my buddy, he was not very well for the past 3 days. So I had sent across a message to my senior JCO that Shyam Singh will not join the war, join the battle. The reason being, we are going for an attack. I don't know how long he's going to take. He has not fully recouped. So let him rest, let him not come. The moment he got to know about this, he came running towards me and quote unquote, verbatim I'm telling you, what is it? He comes and tells me, "Saab, achhe din mein aapke saath tha. Abhi bura waqt aaya hua hai. Main aapko akela kaise chhod dun? Agar aapko kuch ho gaya, imagine he telling, agar aapko kuch ho gaya, to main apne ghar mein, apne paltan mein." And I tell you, you know, the moment I heard this, I said, ki, yaar, look at this chap. He is a soldier whom, you know, Naveen was somebody else, Shyam Singh was somebody else. We had not met each other, we had not even seen each other, we had not heard each other's name. But within a span of 6 months, you know, he's not letting me go into the war alone. He wants to join me. Seeing is, you know, that commitment and dedication, I tell Tubi Salchar, Saath Mein Chal Fir. The fourth afternoon, we had a meal with my Jawans, and then we have some formalities which we follow. You know, there are 100 of my men standing there, the entire Charlie company is standing there. I had just put in about 6 months of service then. I was just about 23, 24 years old, with just 6 months of service behind me. So I had to address my company, Charlie company, and, you know, tell them, explain them the whole scenario, explain them the whole plan of action. And then I'll have to tell them something called an unposted letters. I'll have to tell them your near and dear ones, you can write a letter, whomsoever you want to address. In case you don't come back from war, the letter will be handed over to your near and care ones, whomsoever you address. In case you come back from war, the letter is handed back to you. That is like a last message to the family members or the near and dear ones. It may look simple, it may look pretty simple, you know, the way I told you people, it may look simple, but imagine yourself in my shoes, standing there, you know, telling 100 odd people, telling them that you may not come back from war, so you can write down your last message. Know strong how bold an officer you are. It's a very arduous task, it's a very difficult task. But yes, I had to do that, I did that. There are a lot of people who wrote letters and deposited. I also wrote a letter and then I also deposited. And then subsequently what we do is, all our belongings, whatever we are carrying, our identity card, our ranks, our name tag, our wallets, everything is deposited. The reason being, in case we go for the attack and we are taken prisoner of war, our identity should not be revealed. Who am I? What's my name? What's my rank? What's my unit? Nothing should be revealed. So we are a plain person there, just a soldier. So that's the reason, you know, we had to deposit all the belongings. Again, it looks very, you know, mild and simple to you. So what's the big deal? You have your wallet, you deposit it there. Once you come back, you take it, you collect it, you pick it up. But I have seen, it was such an emotional scene. I have seen so many soldiers taking out their wallets, you know. Probably they had pictures of their, you know, parents, the soldiers' wives' photograph, the soldiers', you know, children's photograph. You know, seeing it intensely, you know, tears rolling down their eyes, giving it up. Maybe thinking that it's a parting kiss, you know, kissing the photographs and then depositing it back. So this is what goes to a soldier's mind. It was about to be dark on 4th of July. Our Panditji was sitting there, conductor was conducting an havan. Once we were conducted, havan was conducted, he applied tilak on my forehead and, you know, on my weapon also. And when he was applying tilak on my forehead, he said, ki, "Saab, himmat nahi harna, aapko bahut aage jana hai." I didn't realize the significance of that particular sentence at that point of time. I don't know why he's saying that. I was only to realize it once I got injured. Now, the last, just before the attack, you know, we meet all the officers. We probably give a firm handshake and a hug. My commanding officer, Colonel YK Joshi, was the first one. I went and met him. you know, had a firm handshake. You know, when he was about to give me a hug, he told me, Naveen, you take care of my men. Men will take care of you. Again, I didn't know the significance of that. One by one, I went to each officer. Last was Captain Vikram Batra, standing there in the corner. No, I was anticipating some punch words from him. You know, he had won the battle of 5140. He was all over the newspapers. Idil Mange Moro had almost become a household name. I had seen his photograph in the front page of the newspaper. His interview was on the TV also. So, you know, I was expecting a punch word from him. The moment I go to him, he gave me a handshake and just about to give me a tight hug, he said, he told me, "Gale lagna yaar, na jaane kaun si mulaqat aakhri hogi." That is the time I realized, here I am, you know, as an officer, young officer, trying to motivate my men. But yes, I realized then, yes, I also may not come back from war. But it hit like a jolt to me. After that, I moved towards my battalion, moved towards my company. Major Gopinath was standing there. And our unit war cry, Nair would be knowing, before we to perform any activity, any event which we conduct, we have a war cry. We shout that war cry. Our unit war cry was Durge Mata Ki Jai. And the moment I said Durge Mata Ki Jai, and 120 people, when once in unison, when they said Durge Mata Ki Jai, it was an electrifying atmosphere. You know, that is the time we were charged up. Till then, probably we had some inhibition, some social obligation, some concern for the family, fear of uncertainty was there. But once we said Durge Mata Ki Jai and headed towards the feature which we had to attack, there was only one thing in mind: come what may. Tricolor has to be hoisted on 148 Sampai. With this intention, 4th July, it was just dark, and then we started our ascent.